That's dad moves right there. It's funny, man. I forgot about that video. That was Kim
Kardashian.
K.
Yeah, a long time ago.
Looking different back in the day right there. Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's one of those ones where, like, you know, we do lots of videos or lots of things, and you're like, I wonder what happened to some of these people. And, like,
with
Kim, you don't really have to wonder. You know what I mean?
No wondering there. Well, one of the things that's always been cool about Fall Out Boy are the song titles themselves. What's up with all the vowels? Why is it spelled with all the vowels?
Okay, so with that one, with the album before, we were told by our label, they were like, the song titles are too long. Like, the radio programmers, like, hate it. And we were like, okay, we'll make them really short. Wink. Like, pick out all the vowels.
And then our lawyer made us change the name of this song so we wouldn't get sued.
That's true. Yeah. So this title was originally called My Name is David Ruffin and These Are the Temptations. And it was like a it was like a play on this whole the Temptations biopic, which is really good. You should check it out. Yeah. But the lawyer at the label was like, you really can't name that if it's not, the song's not about the Temptations at all, you know, whatever.
So we'll,
like,
show you.
Yeah, I guess so. In like a,
there goes creative liberty right there.
Yeah.
So this is cool, man. You're going to be hitting the road, Fall Out Boy on tour with Weezer and Green Day. That's a fun show right there.
Yeah, it's the Hella Mega Tour, and we'll be out basically all next year, stadiums kind of around the world, which is
nice.
Cool.
How's it different now this time around? You got the kids, you got the family. Will they go on the whole tour? How does it work?
We were never really a big party band, so it's like that shift isn't, you know, that different. But the thing that is different is that, you know, when the kids are all out and you get like a bounce house or you know what I mean? Like, it's none of this is, not, tour life is not really totally designed for kids, but at the same time, it's like, they're nothing like a, you know, like maybe 1 to 15-year-old thinks is cooler than a tour bus. You're like on this thing that you could stay up all night and just play video games and just eat whatever you want.
But when they're smaller, I would say even going on vacation, it's like you're just doing the same stuff, but you have to reinvent it elsewhere, right?
Like
it's the one-man show. It's hard.
Totally. We had, when my five-year-old, when he was really little, so there's bunks on the tour bus, and he had one that was just, it was like a built-in crib. Like, we drilled into the wall, and I just, like, have all these visions of him being awake, like, in the middle of the night, like, staring at me from the crib. I was like,
those are sweet. Yeah. You go from popping bottles to baby bottles real quick there.
For sure.
No, but that's cool, man. It does, it's a nice little balance now, right?
Totally.
It's a lot of work, though, kind of, to keep up with both, huh?
Yeah, I think so. What it gives me an appreciation for, not so much on the band side, because, you know, everybody has their ambition and their, but it really gives, I think a lot about, like, you know, single moms, single parents who are juggling it all, you know, and feel like, I feel very lucky, you know.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It makes me appreciate, like, how hard it is, especially moms. See, like, it's like a super full-time, hard, like, you're not always thanked for a job, you know?
Yeah, you're right.
You're never thanked. I always say, stay-at-home mom, there's no meal break, there's no time off, there's no sick day,
One thing I know, you're a big...
Where's Katie
at?
Right, exactly. You're a big Star Wars fan, huh?
Yes, I am.
Yes.
Yeah.
Likewise, are you fired up for the final installments?
I am, and I really... how I feel about it is, like... we just need to land this thing on the aircraft carrier for the sake of my entire childhood. You know what I mean? Like, it really could all go down in flames or not. You know what I mean?
Yeah. How old was it? For me, it was my very first movie I ever saw. I was 7 years old.
Yeah, so my dad says I went to Return of the Jedi in the theater, but I think he maybe says that, so I just feel, you know,
included.
Cool. Yeah, part of it or whatever. Yeah, you know what I mean? But since then, you know what I mean? Since I was really little. So I have all my Star Wars toys from when I was little. My kids have them now, you know.
Yeah, that's so the fun. You get to live vicariously through your kids.
My son has all. They don't make them as good as they used to. Back in our day, all the hands and moves. I mean, we have the original ones that are great.
Mandalorian's very cool, too.
Because you could throw, like, some, like, you know, like, lead in there.
Lead is the best.
Real quick, I want to make sure we get to Top Elf.
So
speaking of kids, this is a show that kids will love, right?
Yeah, so this is a show where kids are competing, and basically, if they win, all the money goes to a charity in their hometown. But they're basically looking to be, like, Santa's Top Elf. Which is cool.
That's so cool. So we're building and making stuff, and they're gonna.
Yeah, the competitions are actually insane.
Wow, that looks next level
This is seriously fun.
And the kids are, like, super creative and super,
Do your kids want to be on this? Like, they got to think this is cool. They like, with your music, it's great, but this show, Dad.
my kids. Like, think it's really cool if I can, like, cook the pancakes right the first time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're, like, very unimpressed with. They don't think any of the other stuff is that cool.
Totally.
Like, whatever. I mean, it's like, you know, it's whatever.
Completely.
Like, they think it's cool to go to the shows because, like, the arenas have, like, ice underneath, and they have hot, you know, like that stuff is
that's
cool.
That's the stuff where they like the hot chocolate they get there, not your performance.
Other than show, that, they're not enjoying the set list.
No, they don't. It's like very unimpressive.
Well, thank you so much, man.
Happy holidays. Great to see you.
Big thanks to Pete Top. Elf airs Friday night at 8 on Nickelodeon. Season finale is...